So we're really excited to show you this brief video. I'll warn you, it's a little choppy because of the connection here between this monitor and this screen. But you guys are actually, we're excited because you're one of the first ones outside of ARUP Lab to actually see the Workcell. So I'm going to walk through just a little bit of it. So this is our Workcell sitting on a precise arm. We're moving through. We have two stackers, a foreseen and ambient. This actually has all of our consumables and samples and everything. Pretty much anything the Workcell needs. Moving down this precise rail to one of our handoff nest locations. So we have, there's a lot of empty space on that first rail, but that's for future expansion plans that we have. So we went ahead and built the system planning for the next few 5 years or so. And now it's a little bit of a delay here, but switching arms. And then you'll see the first two of two T-cans. So we're on the clean side of the lab right now. So all of the pre-amplification sections, but we have two TCAN 1080s. Both of these do all the library prep, and these are really the workhorses of the system itself. Coastal genomics, we have a light bench for all of our QC. Agilent centrifuge for just quick spin downs. We just have a few small spin downs. We have a CAPS 500 sticky sealer for the Covaris plate, and then of course the Covaris, which we'll talk about in a little bit more detail. This is our beautiful Covaris that we worked with Covaris again to go through. So then passing through the airlock, so we're now moving on to the dirty side. So obviously in production, there's a wall here and these sides won't actually be open at the same time to eliminate contamination. But move to our other precise arm, we have another handoff nest. And if you've seen that there's actually some biohazard bins on the system itself, it's because as reagents expired or used, the system auto-disposes them versus leaving them on the line. We also have two TCAN 1080s. Again, three arm systems. We have components above and components below doing all of the different work that needs to be done for these, for the NGS prep. We also then here coming up on our stacker of eight on-the-deck thermal cyclers that were taken off the deck. this was to free up our T-cans to do a lot more processing instead of having to just be used up for thermal cyclers. Again, another centrifuge, and then our combi dancer. So there's one component where you have to dry down the samples before hybridization. So we actually went with the combi dancer to dry down those samples because no one really makes an automated vacuumfuge, including Hedge, which all they make is automated centrifuges. So. And then again, another 4C and ambient stacker. And this line actually looks pretty long, and it is, so it goes across two different rooms, but that's necessary for the amount of testing that we're talking about and the different complexity of the testing that we have.